after the fourth period, we go to our class, we have to move first.
We go to math.
Okay.
I'll call you back. Okay, in our lesson 3.4, we are dividing now. So we have done multiplication, or we have done addition, we have done subtraction, we have done multiplication, and now we are doing division of monomials. So I'm going to show you the expanded form, so hopefully it helps you remember the rule. When I see x to the fifth, and I pointed this out, I did expanded form when we did multiplication. That means x multiplied 5 times. X to the third means x multiplied 3 times. And I would cancel, and I would cancel, and I would cancel, and I would end up with 2 of them on top, or x to the second power. Now, we don't want to write all of that out for every question that we do, so we have a rule that we can follow. If we look at the original question, and the answer that I got when I wrote it all out, all I needed to do was subtract those powers. 5 minus 3 is 2. So the rule, when you are dividing, is to subtract powers. So we have done nothing with powers. We have done questions where we have added powers. We have done questions where we have multiplied powers. Now the new one is, when we're dividing, we're gonna subtract them. Yes?
I have a question about, it's not about this, but on number 9 on the test, the answer, okay, well, for example, I'm just gonna use a random number. 6, it was like 6x2, and then like farther along, there was a like 6y2, will you combine those?
But no. X1.
The multiplying can't get.
Okay.
All right, expanded form here. X to the third over x to the third, xxx times xxx. This would all cancel out, which makes it equal to 1. But if we applied the rule that I just said, where you subtract the powers when you're dividing, I would get x to the 0. So when I did it one way, where I wrote it all out, I got an answer of 1. But when I did it a different way using my rule, I got x to the 0. And they're both correct. So that gives me my second rule. Anything to the 0 power equals 1. So rule number 2, anything to the 0 power equals 1. Rule number 3, in expanded form, again, we can write it out, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And I would cancel, and I would cancel, and I would cancel. And I would be left with x to the fourth in the denominator. That's where the x's are left, which would leave me an understood 1 in my numerator. So writing it out in expanded form, that's what happens. But if I follow my rule, I said subtract 3 minus 7, I get x to the negative fourth power.
And we can do it anyway, right?
No, I'll show you what we're doing. We use the rule a couple different ways. So again, one way we wrote it out, one way we did it, we got 2 different looking answers, and they are also equal, they're equivalent. So what this rule is going to tell me is that anytime I have a negative power, I am going to move it to the opposite place, meaning top to bottom, bottom to top, and make it a positive power. With an understood 1 in the numerator if needed. three things I want you to get. When I'm dividing, I'm subtracting exponents. When I have a negative power, I'm going to move the power. And when I have a power of zero, that just equals one. We're going to try to not work with negative powers as much as we can, okay? So the method that I'm going to use is going to try to eliminate the negative exponents, which makes it easier because then we do subtraction with positives always and not negatives, okay? Okay, question number one. I am dividing. Remember that when there's not a power, it is understood to be a one. Not necessary to write it, but you still have to know that. So on my x's, 5 minus 2 is x to the third. On my y's, 4 minus 1 is y to the third. That is my answer. On B, they're exactly the same. So they simply cancel out. Read the fourth, same exponent, so they cancel. C to the third, 6 over C to the third. 6 minus 3 is 3. And on F, 8 minus 5 is 3. Examples, the exponents in the numerator were larger than the exponents in the denominator, which is why the variable ended up on top. So we're going to use that rule two ways. Here's our second way. On my x, 3 minus 2 is 1, which I can write or not. On my y's, they're exactly the same, so they cancel each other out. On my z's, 8 minus 6 is 2, but that's going to be left in the denominator. So we're not going to make the power negative and then move it. We're going to subtract in the direction of the larger power because, again, think about expanded form. If I wrote z out 6 times, 5, 6, and I wrote z out 8 times, and I canceled, I end up with them on the bottom. So we're not going to do expanded form, okay? We're not going to write all of that out. We're going to know that we subtract, and wherever the power is bigger is where they end up, okay? So wherever the power is bigger, that's where they end up when you do that subtraction. So 8 minus 6, 2 on the bottom. Okay, the rule for negative powers is simply you move it. So we're going to move that, and we're going to move that. My x to the third is going to stay where it is. My y to the negative second is going to move to the denominator and become a positive 2 exponent. And my z to the negative seventh is going to move up and become a positive 7. All of my variables are different, so that's as far as I can go. So when there's a negative exponent on a letter, you move it to the opposite place, top to bottom, bottom to top, and make it positive. Anything to the zero power equals 1. So there's no work to do on that question. 1 is my answer. I'm going to move these two terms. So my x the negative 3 is going to go down to the denominator. My y to the 5th is going to stay where it is. My x to the 12th is going to stay where it is. My y to the negative 4th, that's going to move up so the power can become positive. So again, anything with a negative power moves. Then I simplify. Both of my x's are on the bottom, which means we're multiplying, which means we add them. 15. 3 plus 12. Both of my y's are on the top, which means we're multiplying, which means you add. 5 plus 4 is 9. That's my answer. We're going to move that. The rest stay. So x to the 9th stays. Y to the negative 8 moves down. Z to the negative 12 moves down. Then I go to the denominator. X to the 15th stays. Y to the negative 18th goes up. And Z to the 2nd stays. So on my X's, top and bottom, which means I'm going to subtract. 15 minus 9 is 6. 15 is bigger, so that goes on the bottom. No negative powers on this one. So I'm going to divide. 24 divided by 12 is 2. Coefficients never move. So x to the negative 3rd comes down, y to the negative 8 comes down, x to the negative 10th goes up, y to the negative 5th goes up. So every variable moved from either top to bottom or bottom to top became positive. I divide. 14 over 7 is 2. Subtract my powers. 10 minus 3 is 7 on the top. 8 minus 5 is 3 on the bottom. So when I subtract, wherever the larger power is where it ends up. Last one. That, and that, and that, and that. So again, I'm only moving the letters that have a negative power on them. So x squared stays. Y to the negative 7th goes down. Z to the negative 10th goes down. X to the negative 3rd goes up. Y to the 2nd stays. And Z to the negative 3rd goes up. So I have 18 over 3 is 6. X's are both on the top. So we're going to add those powers. Y's are both on the bottom. So we're going to add those powers. And Z's top and bottom. So we're going to subtract. 10 minus 3 is 7. Left on the bottom because 10 is bigger than 3.